Hello friends, welcome back to CNS Groups of Company. Today in this video we will be having a basic introduction of what is strength of materials. In any building or any analysis type, we will be majorly looking at what are the different type of support conditions and the loading conditions for our analysis to be completed. So in this video we will have a very basic introduction of what are the different types of end supports, what are the reactions developed due to different supports and the different loading conditions. At the first, we will look into what are the different types of support conditions that are available. So, basically we have four types of support conditions. The first one being fixed support. So, when we talk about fixed support, it is the name itself suggests that the support is completely rigid in nature. It is not allowable to move in any direction. So, this is what the symbol that we use for fixed support. So, when we have no movement in any directions, the number of reactions that would develop would be in three principal directions. So first one would be a vertical force, you can name it as VA, and the second would be a horizontal force that can be known as HA, and the third one will be a rotational one that is nothing but your moment. So fixed support will have a vertical force, a horizontal force and a moment. So at the same time when we come into the second one, that is the hinge support. So hinge support is something which allows you to move in one direction. So it allows the movement of this, it allows the rotation of the support but not the translation of the support. So this means that you have two developed reactions, that is horizontal vertical reaction and an horizontal reaction. So we will be having two reactions for any hinge support. And the third one is a roller support. This is something wherein you have one allowable movement for translation and another allowable movement for your rotation. So which side that is it resisting is nothing but the vertical movement is not being allowed. So we develop one vertical movement, that is PC. So the number of reactions for a roller support would be 1. When you come into another type of support, that is the last one, that is the free end. So as the name suggests, it's completely free. So you have freedom to move in any direction, maybe in both the translatory motions or in the rotation motion. So the number of directions that is available is in all three directions. So the number of reactions for a free end is 0. Yeah, coming to the second point that we started with. So that's nothing but the type of loading conditions. So we have different types of loading conditions when we come to the practical analysis. But basically for any type of loading conditions, you need three loading conditions. That is nothing but your point load. So point load is nothing but a concentrated load that is acting at one particular point. So this is represented something like this. So we have a beam of L length and a point load of W kilonewton is acting on this load. So when we are doing any analysis with respect to this type of loading conditions, then we take the entire load W as it is when we are doing the analysis. When the second type of loading is commonly known as UDL, this is nothing but uniformly distributed load. So this load is something that we come across on a major note when we are into the designing field. So what is this UDL? Is nothing but it is a rectangular load, a load that is spread over the entire area. So when we consider this beam, so this is a cross section of the beam, we can see the length of the beam. So we have another dimension called as width. So this load will be acting on both the length and the width of the beam. So the load will be given with a concentration of W kilonewton per meter. So when we are doing analysis of such type of loads, you need to resolve this load and then you have to use it for your analysis. So how do we resolve it is nothing but we take the area of the load. So what is the area that we can look into? This is nothing but your load W into whatever the length of beam that is being provided. So you get something called as the concentrated load that will be in kilonewton. So where will this load be acting? It will be acting at the centroid. So for a rectangle, the centroid is nothing but center, that is L by 2 from each of the supports. So coming to the third type of This is also majorly used when we do the analysis in SET. So this is nothing but UVL, a similar one, but it is a uniformly varying load. So as you can see, the intensity at one support starts from zero, and at the other support it reaches to the maximum. So it is nothing but a linearly varying load with respect to the distance. So in this type of loads also, we need to resolve the load. Again, the same concept comes into play. It is nothing but taking the area of the load. So as you can see, the shape resembles the triangle. As we know, triangle's area is nothing but half base into height. So the same thing will be using here, half. So what is the base out here? It is nothing but your length of the beam. That is L into the height is nothing but the maximum intensity of the load. That is nothing but again W. So when we do this, we get the load in kilometer. So where will be this acting? It is again the same thing. This will be acting at the centroid. So when you have a triangle like this, the centroid will be acting at 2L by 3 from toe and L by 3 from the base. So this is your toe and this is nothing but your base. Hope you had a good time with this video. Thank you so much.